Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 11 of our GoLang course. In this session, we will delve into bitwise logical operators. So let's commence our exploration. We have previously covered the concept of bits. Let us now take a moment to refresh our memories. Bits serve as the fundamental language of computers, where data is stored and processed in binary form of ones and zeros. The smallest unit of memory is a bit. It is capable of holding either a 0 or a 1. It is also referred to as unset for 0 bit and set for when the bit is 1. Bitwise operators are utilized to perform low-level bit manipulation, or simply put, carrying out operation at the bit level. Example of bit manipulation in computer science encompass cryptography algorithms, system programming, network programming, device drivers, and more. These scenarios demand manipulation at the bit level. The decimal numbers commonly used are known as base 10 numbers, while binary numbers represent base 2 numbers. To gain a thorough understanding of bitwise operators, it is crucial to comprehend how decimal numbers can be represented using the binary equivalent. For further exploration of binary numbers, you can find additional resources in the video description. The OR operator is represented by a single bar sign is utilized to perform the OR operation. It compares two bits in the number and sets the resultant bit if either of the bit is set. We have a table to aid your understanding of the operation. The table contains two bits where first bit is represented by A and the second bit is represented by B. The table encompasses all combinations of 0 and 1. First, we have 00 for both A and B. Since the OR operator sets the resultant bit if either bit is set, which is not the case here, the result will be 0 or unset bit. Next, we have 0 for A and 1 for B. As B is set, the resultant bit will be set as well. Next, we have 1 for A and 0 for B. Again, since A bit is set, the resultant bit will be set as well. Lastly, we have 1 for both A and B. Since both the bits are set, the result will be a set bit too. To summarize, the OR operator sets the resultant bit if either bit is set. Or, in simpler terms, if either bit of the two bits is 1, the resultant bit will be 1. In this example, we are given two decimal numbers represented by their binary counterparts. The first number is 202, with the binary representation is 11001010. The second number is 141. The binary representation is 10001101. When the binary operation is performed, it is carried out at the bit level. Let's talk through the example. We will perform the OR operation of each pair of corresponding bits from both binary numbers. From the left bit, or the most significant bit, the bits are 1 and 1 in both the numbers. So, the OR operation results in a 1. Moving to the second left bit, we have 1 for the first number and 0 for the second. The OR operation will again result in 1. Next, we have 00. Since no bit is set, the result is 0. Same is with the next one. Since no bit is set, the result will be 0. Again, we have 11. Since both the bits are set, the result will be 1. Then 01 results in 1. 10 results in 1. 01 results in 1. After performing the OR operation on all corresponding pairs of bits, the resultant binary number is 11001111, or in decimal 207. Next, let us discuss the bitwise AND operator. The bitwise AND operator sets the resultant bit to 1 only if both the bits are set or are equal to 1. In contrast, if either or both the bits are 0, the resultant bit will be 0. Here is the table once again demonstrating the all possible combination of two bits. First, we have 00 for A and B, which will result in 0. Next, we have 01, which will again result in 0. Next, we have 10, which will again result in 0. Next, we have 11, for which the result will be 1. As you know, the resultant bit will be only set when both the bits are 1, which is the case here. So to summarize, AND operator sets the resultant bit if both the bits are set, or resultant bit is 1 only when both bits are 1. An intriguing fact about AND operator is that when number A is even, A and 1 will result in 0. On the other hand, if the number A is odd, A and 1 will result in 1. Now let's perform the AND operation between two binary numbers bit by bit. these numbers are the same numbers that we have used in the previous example. From the leftmost bit, or the most significant bit, we have one in A and one in B. The AND operation sets the resultant bit to 1 only if both the bits are set, which is the case here. Therefore, the AND operation will yield 1. Next, we have 10, which means the resultant bit will be 0. Next, we have 0 and 0, which means the resultant bit will be 0. 0 and 0 again, resultant is 0. Next, we have 1 and 1, which means the AND condition is satisfied, so we can say the resultant is 1. Next, we have 0, 1, which results in a 0 again. 1, 0 results in a 0 again. 0, 1 results in a 0 again. So, after performing the AND operation on each corresponding pairs of bits, the resultant binary number is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, or the decimal representation 136. Let's take a small break here. And in part 2 of the video, we will cover XOR and more bitwise operators in Go. So see you in part 2 of this lesson.